We're speaking here with Russell Latapy, head coach of our national men's under 20 team. Russell, obviously preparation is ongoing. There are tournaments ahead in this 2018 calendar. How things gone so far?
Not too bad, Sean. You know, we know that it's always a challenge. You know, what we've tried to do as a staff is to keep the team together. I think previously, what has happened is that we had a lot of long breaks. What we're doing with this team is having these teams training at least once a week. We know that our tournament is scheduled in November. We still have to incorporate some of the overseas-based players who we think are good enough players to get onto this team. But in the meantime, we're ongoing. What we're trying to enhance in these players is the game awareness and the tactical awareness and obviously the fitness level. We have a good bunch of players here that that we think we can work with. But in comparison to the teams that we're going to be competing against, we're competing against young players who are already playing first team football in top professional leagues. So it's always going to be a challenge, but we've got a great bunch of young men here who is taking on a lot of information and they're willing to work hard. So that's a good place to start from.
One of the things that we've noticed in recent times, there are some constraints being faced by the footballing body, by the association. How does this factor in to your preparations and how are you working around this?
Listen, it is always a massive challenge. You know, I think for most coaches, ideally, what you'd really like before any tournament would be, and being kind here, six to eight international games. We know that that because of the financial constraint of the Federation at this point, it's difficult to get these international games. So therefore, what we're trying to do here right now is we're trying to play in the local league, either the Pro League or the Super League. So we're hoping that we're going to get the support not only from the Federation and this, but also from the Super League or the Pro League. It's happened in the past before that we've seen that when the teams are local teams, the local national team play in the local leagues, then it's having an impact on the way that they perform in terms of game preparation. So we're hoping that we're going to get this support from the football fraternity because we're not going to get the international game. So that's the way we're trying to work around it.
How are you and your staff, Russell, keeping tabs on our opponents in CONCACAF as well as potential players outside of Trinidad and Tobago who could be knocking on your door?
Well, you know, there are plans right now that the technical director is involved with, and this is we want to do a foreign camp where we would give players the opportunity to come and join this camp where we can have a chance to look at these players and see which one of these players would benefit what we're trying to do here. As I said, though, you know, and as everybody knows, it is always challenging. Most of the stuff we're doing here as a staff, you know, and simple things like, you know, we train to keep the boys together, and we try to call training at 4 o'clock because we have players who live in different directions. You know, it's difficult for all the players to get here at 4 o'clock all the time. You know, so it's just little minor challenges like this that there is not much we can do about it. You know, today we planned a session, and like many other days, this has happened, and we couldn't really do the session based on the numbers of players we have and based on some of the important players we have. You know, today, for example, we've got one goalkeeper at training today. I know there's still a long way, and we're going to clamp down on this, but these are some of the improvements that we would like to see.
And obviously your job away from the training pitch continues on an ongoing basis in terms of staying aware of what is happening in the rest of the region.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, when you look at the teams who ideally we're going to compete again, you know, no disrespect to any of the Caribbean islands, you know, we know Haiti and Jamaica are doing really well right now, but we know that if we want to qualify for any World Cup tournament, then really we have to compete with the Mexicos and the Costa Ricas and the USAs. So they're the ones that we're keeping an eye on, and we're seeing what they're doing, we're seeing the players they have, we're doing our homework on them, and we're just going to try to do the best with what we have. Like I said, for me, I have a great bunch of players here in terms of attitude. They're willing to work really hard. They're taking on a lot of the information that we have. And I can say from a year ago or so when I took the team on to where we are now, I think we are much improved.
Russell, thank you very much. Always a pleasure.